Hello, everyone, and thank you to DJ and Juicebox Guy for breaking down the action in our first two games. We do have POS 2 coming in here just a second to get our interview rolling. Hopefully, we can get him in here awfully soon. But, Doctor, it's a wonderful performance, and here he is, POS 2 in the mid lane. How are you doing, my friend?
You know, I won't lie. After those two games, I feel like I just got punched in the gut, kicked in the teeth, thrown to the curb. That game felt like an 0-2. I will not lie, but we took the win anyway.
You know, I kind of understand, right? You guys are at the top of the table. You're playing against a mid-table team, and I really wanted to ask you as my first question: did it feel as good as it felt to watch? And obviously, the answer is no. You guys had a troublesome time. What do you think then was the was the reasoning for that struggle you guys had?
You know, I gotta say, I think a lot of it comes down to the fact that we just didn't get our daily dose of ketamine in our pregame practice because all the servers were down, all that fun stuff. You know, the team just didn't get to play ranked today. So I would go ahead and blame Riot for this loss. Or win, but loss, you know?
Okay, I think that's definitely respectable. And so while the team itself kind of struggled, you definitely got to play League of Legends. I mean, you came in on the Yone game one. It was a bit of a rough rot, but then you came back and you ran the Viego back. And that looked, with some problems, definitely looked a lot better. Are these picks that you guys were kind of planning into tonight, or was it just kind of a, hey, they're open, let's do it?
There were definitely a couple picks that we pulled out of the hat that we haven't been practicing, but the Viego is definitely one of our staples. I think that champion is completely insane. Definitely blue on every game. So yeah.
Fair enough. I mean, the Viego looked incredible. That insane flank in the last team fight. Obviously, you guys were ahead at that point, but basically one-shotting Blazing Bronze on the Senna as the main carry. You really can't ask any more. Looking ahead, though, into future weeks, as we have to get into our matchups, you guys are at the top of the table. Wins are wins, and W's under the W column still have to feel relatively nice at the end of the night. So who is your main challenger? Who are you guys looking at going into the week saying, you know what, you're the team that if we beat, there's no shot we don't get first place?
Oh yeah, no, we've realized already that we're not going to lose this league. The league's just over. We should pack it up early. It's just no team can stand to us.
So no one is then
Nobody.
Your answer? No
Nobody.
One even comes close? All right.
No, not
Fair
at
enough.
All.
Not even VBO, the returning kings.
Not even VBO.
I mean, to be fair, VBO is currently sitting in third with only 8 points after our departure of FGCU. So, I mean, yeah, VBO, they're whatever. They're old kings. Crowns fall and fade away. But, you know, as the Glaive brand, right, you guys are coming in off of a very solid mid-league victory. I know that it's a different team than what you guys are. But do you guys think that maybe there's a bit of overconfidence heading into playoffs, kind of like we saw from our main team, CGCU, from last season, where they came into playoffs absolutely undefeated and lost in the semis to VBO?
No, not at all. We're very confident that we will be sweeping this league under the rug very quickly.
Okay. Even after what we just saw there?
Absolutely. Today was a little bit of a fluke, I would say.
You know what? I love the confidence. I mean, as a man with confidence, you got to just stick to it and stick to your
Absolutely.
Guns.
I'm not going to make it sound nice, you know.
I mean, you don't sugarcoat it. If you're saying you're going to sweep the league, sweep the league. The only last question I have for you comes from my friend Juicebox Guy, who is Eloquence, and do we have to worry about his crush on Klonk Gronk Zonk?
Because Juicebox Eloquence is, you know, he's a great guy. He's one of Klonk's closest members of his tribe, of his cult. And he supports him all the way. So he is Klonk's biggest fan.
Does Klonk even know who Juicebox Guy is?
I'm sure Klonk has an inkling.
So who's more important to Klonk, do you think? Eloquence or Juicebox Guy?
Oh, well, like, I won't lie. Like, it has to be Eloquence. Like, Juicebox Guy just, I'm sorry, man.
All right, well, thanks for coming on POS and on that bombshell.
I can hear Juicebox Guy's tears in the background. Anyway, but thank you so much, POS2. We have to get into our second tonight. But okay, thank you so much, PS2, for joining us once again. Go celebrate your win and good luck in your second set of the night.
Yeah, thank you so much. Have a good night.
And with that, we will throw it back to our analyst desk once again, Juicebox Guy. Please wipe your tears away as I stall for you a little bit longer, but can't give you too much more time. Take it away, boys, as we get ready for Lotus versus